So in the first 3 months of the fall 2017 term, which is the academic term of the university, the Office of Admissions experienced a hike in negative phone calls from transfer students, as well as a hike in employee resignations. Good evening, everyone. Board members, my name is Andrea Molina. I work for the Office of Undergraduate Admissions. I've been working for the department for 3 years and have over 10 years of experience in higher education. My recommendation today for the solution for these matters is the designations of transfer advisors to transfer students. Unfortunately, the university made an overnight change to the process of admitting upper-level transfer students, meaning students coming in with 90 college credits or more. So my solution is to designate those transfer advisors for three purposes: to allow transfer students to have a clear plan, second, to shorten the admissions decision period. Right now, transfer students have to wait at least 3 months for a decision on their admissions process. Third, to reduce the student and staff dissatisfaction. Clarity and support to the student is something that the university is at the vanguard in. Right now, we hired someone who specializes in appreciative advisory, so let's be part of the solution, and let's be part of the program that we actually hired. When you assign a transfer student, a transfer advisor to a transfer student, you'll be able to answer the questions that the Office of Admission is unable to. Most of the frequently asked questions that transfer students have is, how do the credits transfer? How many credits transfer? Can I meet with someone? Right? So very important. Those are questions that the Office of Admissions is unable to answer. The Office of Admissions is the central point that everyone goes to when they can't find the answers to. So very important, instead of relying on the Office of Admissions on helping, on trying to assist these students in these aspects, assigning a transfer advisor is the ideal. One of the things that I found out as I was researching is that students actually enroll in institutions that, when they meet someone that is friendly and knowledgeable, they're most likely to enroll. Right now, a student reported to USAA College Today that even though changing the processes between institutions is easy, what they found out most helpful is finding that person that they connected with. Right now, the Office of Admissions is about, basically it's taking 3 months to be able to decide on these files. As you can see, this is the current process. In between the college and the admissions decision is 3 months, and with my recommended process, we would reduce it to less than 3 steps. Jordan Sackle, and actually an expert in higher education, reported that thanks to today's technology and information age, the customer demands does not change when the customer becomes a student. Just like in retail, a student demands its product to be delivered as soon as possible. That's the same way it is for our students. Third and not least, it also reduces student and admission staff dissatisfaction. When the student calls wanting to find out about answers, obviously they do contact the Office of Admissions, but if the Office of Admissions does not have the information, it's not able to rely to the student. When the student doesn't get the information, the student calls back, complains to the dean, complains to the Office of the President, and that's where we get all these negative calls. Now, negative calls result in a staff dissatisfaction and as well as, obviously, bad reputation for the university. Dr. Reicher, who is a consultant to not only public institutions but governmental institutions, he does say that governmental institutions, because they've been working the same way for a long time, they lack innovation, they lack communication, they have the hardest time of retaining employees. Therefore, ladies and gentlemen, it's time to innovate and it's time to communicate with our students. All right now, our competitors are University of Central Florida and Florida International University. They have been engaging for transfer students for a long time. They have full active transfer and transition services offices where they call their transfer advisors peer advisors. The institution has recently put together a transfer office that right now, the advisors, the transfer advisors, instead of advising, are out there recruiting instead of sitting down with students to seeing what their academic plan is. So, ladies and gentlemen of the board, I suggest instead of making our students go to different departments, run off to other different institutions, let's start sitting down with them, talking to them for a plan, and setting them up for success. Any questions? Yes.
Is it really cost effective to have one-on-one time with each particular student? Because isn't that going to be a lot of undergrads and transfer students coming into the school?
But upper level transfers.
Okay.
Upper level transfer. It's a little bit confusing for me to, you know, because there's different types of transfer students. We have upper level transfer students that come in with 90 college credits. When you finish an undergraduate degree, you only need 120. Now, when a student comes into an institution with 90 college credits, there's something going on. Either something happened at the other institution, or maybe you're a veteran that skipped maybe four or five institutions, or you have that job that took you all over the place. And a student with 90 college credits should not be transferring. They should have stayed where they are and graduated. But because of the situation, we do need to sit down and hear it from the student to see what's going on.
Well, how many do you receive for every semester?
The problem came up. We had 100 from August all the way to November. We had 160 files sitting of professionals like you and us waiting for an answer from the university, see if they can come and finish their degree. So it basically, they applied in August, and in November we still had not given an answer because they were sitting on the dean's office. Yes?
So my question is, so I saw the timeline in terms mm-hmm. of cutting it down to a mm-hmm. three-step process, mm-hmm. but then are they eliminating the piece of going out to the college? Because I didn't see the college dean on there. So
yes.
I'm wondering how that piece
yes.
and how well
yes.
received will that be in terms of switching to this kind of a methodology.
Basically, when a student applies, we collect the file and we give it to the dean.
Right.
Before we hear it to the dean, it's 3 months. Meaning that the dean has to do the job of the advisor. That's why.
Okay.
So in this case, we would have the advisor do the academic advising. They tell admissions office, and they can just enroll because these students don't need orientation or anything.
I see.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
How many additional staff members are you proposing that you hire?
We already have. We already have a transfer and transition office that we're not using wisely. We're having them recruit instead of being academic
okay.
advisors. Yes.
So your plan technically doesn't require hiring additional staff members, is just
training.
Repurposing the ones that you already
yeah.
have.
Repurposing and training.
So there's virtually no cost.
Basically no cost.
Oh.
Yeah.
That's what I was
okay.
asking.
Yes.
Well, but I mean, training always has a cost. I'm wondering, would you bring
yeah.
someone in from the outside? Would it be some sort of third party?
The nice part is that the transfer and transition office is made by people who were already internals. So they can be academically, they can be trained as academic advisors by what the department wants.
Mm-hmm. You wouldn't need any sort of third party to come in?
No, I did an analysis, if obviously I work for the institution, so I know how long each person in the transfer office has been working for FAU. One of them has been there for 10 years.
Mm-hmm.
So since she's been an evaluator, the other one has been an academic advisor for the College of Science. So in reality, it would be repurposing most of the people in the transfer office. Because it's a new office that was made last year, are people internal, people that were just moved up.
So the original timeline has it about, what would you say, on average, current is 6 months? Put it at based on that, and then if moving to your recommended process would be about what turnaround time?
When I was receiving answers from the dean, let's say that students were signing up for classes the week before classes start. So in December, before we left for a break, people were rushing to sign up for classes starting in January. It was very unfortunate.
And the new process, you would think that they would be able to get it mm-hmm. a few months in advance, or?
That's right. For example, the University of Central Missouri also has a transfer and transition office. What they do is that you can set up an appointment with an advisor. You sit down, you go through a plan, whether it to be a general studies degree or to proceed in the degree that you are. Once that contract is agreed upon, then you can send it off to admissions, and yes, this person is admissible.